This is the Earth, you know, on the Ghost Show. Once again, y'all at our favorite spot. You know it. Go Day Landing. We're gonna go ahead and shoot the grand by you today. Got a late start today, y'all. Weather, rain. Now they talking about another storm supposed to be coming in after 12. Some more rain, so we're gonna see what we can do today. We're gonna see if we can catch them sackling on a rainy kind of day. So y'all stay tuned for home in the safety corner next.
Good morning once again. We're down here at Go Day's Landing. Another episode of the Eric and Uncle on the Go Show. Last episode we did a very extensive issue concerning the importance, use, and maintenance of fire extinguishers. But today we're going to touch on something which will be a continuance of that just a little bit. And we're not going to hold you up with too many details. But the point and purpose of the issue is to bring attention to things that we consider to be important enough to mention, and hopefully if 10 people stand witness to these videos, and one person of the 10 heeds the information to a point whereby it saves he or she any type of grief, heartache, problems, or issues out here on the water, that's going to be worth it for us. If one person out of 10 benefits from it, so be it. We're rewarded. And we find that to be a good thing. But anyway, what we're going to talk about right now is some of the things that are basically causal to circumstances that require the use of a fire extinguisher. If we can't eliminate or most sensibly minimize some of the things that are causal to a need for a fire extinguisher, that puts us in a better place. I worked for many years out in offshore issues out in the Gulf of Mexico. And you'd be surprised. Doesn't matter the size of the vessel, the size of the structure. If you get out there and there's a fire on board, whatever you're on board, everything gets a whole lot smaller, a lot quick. So you want to minimize or eliminate the need for a fire extinguisher. One thing in particular reference we want to make today are the common things that occur. And that is, when you go and fill up your fuel tanks on your way to go fishing, coming out on the water, you have a tendency to have it said, I'm going to go and top off my tanks. Well, top off is nomenclature for going out there. We're going to fill the tank up to the point whereby we're comfortable that we got a full tank. But do not take it literally. We advise you not to top off the tank as such. One thing about those fuels, gas or whatnot, it has a tendency to expand when it's heated, when it's hot. Ambient temperature could raise the temperature of what's in your fuel tank, in your lower compartments. And that fuel will swell. It will, get there to a point whereby if you got it full up to the top, well then when it expands, well then you may have some issues with spillage. So if you can eliminate the spillage, we can go a long way towards preventing a fuel problem. The other thing you want to have is that if you look at the three sides that are required in the triangle of combustion, it requires fuel, oxygen, and also requires source of ignition. If you minimize or eliminate potential sources of ignition, minimize potential sources of fuel, well then you go a long way in preventing any particular hazard associated with a need for a fire extinguisher. So when you're doing your maintenance on your batteries, checking out the status of your batteries, make sure your connections are good, solid, and sound. Make sure that any wires or harnesses going to your batteries, you don't have splices that might pull apart, things that might disengage. And if you have an intermittent disengagement of your wiring apparatuses, that produces an immediate propensity for a spark. And when you have a spark, well, then you've got a source of ignition. If you have a contained space, the fuel itself is not flammable, but it's the gases from the fuel. And as these fuels are heated up, you have further expansion of the gases, and you have a potential propensity for ignition. So if we minimize the propensity of spilled fuel, and you minimize or eliminate the propensity of ignition, you've gone a long way to having a good day. And when you boil it all down, if you're going out where we go, doing the things we do, want to have a good cycling fishing day. So you can go back home with the same peace of mind you had when you left home. And if that happens, either way, fish caught, fish not caught, you've had a good day. That's you, your family, friends, associates, whomever it may be that's with you out on the water. We see you out there, give us a wave. And if you have any questions or issues, things that you might want to see brought up, any close calls, any near misses that you may have experienced, been a witness to or a party to, give us a call, give us a kickback, you know, let us know something. And we'll go ahead and if you like to, we'll name you as being the contributor, and we'll have a discussion about that area, aspect of safety, as it may assist and pertain to everyone else. Take care, have a good day. Hurricane Uncle on the out.
Right, y'all. Out here on our favorite spot. Kinda got a least thought. Where we going at?
Check out the bridge.
Gonna check out the bridge again? Put out here and check out this bridge right here.
Crowded.
See what's going on before we make a move. But we're gonna coast on down there. See, we gotta find us some sackley down there. Yeah, buddy. Oh.
Hey.
Tied any new jigs last night on?
Not last night. Tied some night before last.
Y'all keep an eye on them new jigs we got. I must have tied about 11 of them last night.
You did? I saw the picture you sent.
Yeah, they look good too, yeah, they look good. Look like fire. Nice. Yeah, I don't know about you, but I'm ready to pull them big ones up. I'll get them on. Them pretty sackley today. Put them in the boat. At least start. I mean, we got to fish twice as hard.
I don't know about that. Many times we didn't get into the fish until in the afternoon. Many times.
That's right,
huh? Time you start. Just time spent out on the water, which is always a good thing. We don't complain about that. But when you locate the fish, sometimes it takes a period of time to locate them, but then you start getting busy. It's our busy time I'm concerned about. If we can get busy locating and catching fish, we'll be all right.
All right, y'all, we just want to let y'all know that been keeping an eye on our raffle. Right now we got 55 subscribers, almost there. Soon we reach the 100. You know what I'm saying? We're going to go ahead and put them in the hat, and we'll be giving y'all a call, emailing y'all, let y'all know on the show the winners. So once we pick the winners, just go ahead and email us back with your address so we can do a mail off. Alright?
I'd like to go ahead also and put in a little push for the people we support down here. That's Papa Joe and Miss Sarah Goday at Goday's Landing, right here at Pierre Park, just south of the Pierre Park Bridge. And if you can patronize them, I'm sure they would appreciate it. And with their hospitality and nice waves, you'll be rewarded every time you have occasion to see them. So put that in as a quick one.
All right,
that's
Goday Landing, Papa Joe and Miss Sarah. Yep, y'all, we're gonna try and see what this bridge got to offer right here.
Well,
Uncle, let's try another spot on. Yeah, some action underneath the bridge. Baby goo, y'all. Baby goo. Baby goo. First fish of the day in the boat. Not what we're looking for. You know, but the goo got in the way of my sackle, eh? Way it go, y'all. Oh, I'm gonna throw you back there, goo. Goo. Hold up, goo. I tell you what, they got some pointy fins there. On that goo, you gotta watch out. When you're handing them bad boy. Tell you that.
Very cool, very cool.
Yep. That's what it looks like, huh? Like it's gonna come to us like that. First sackalette in the boat. That sackalette. And he put mess up his eye, though. Uncle put him in the eye. Yeah, we're gonna let him go, but I ain't letting him go on. His eye popped out.
Sackalette,
yeah.
What you got there, huh? Alright, we got a nice sackle here. Best one of the day so far. We got something a lot bigger than him. So he's a rock and roller for the moment. Nice sackle.
Sackle,
sackle,
y'all.
Nice
sackle,
Ricky, man.
Best one of the day so far. We're getting better as we go. It's better as they go, huh? Irk and Unk show from the 504 and 225.
I started something now.
Yeah, buddy.
Now you come through the 225.
That's right.
From the 504.
That's what I'm saying.
Once you say 504.
Nah, they got a lot of wood over there. There might be another one over there where I just caught that one.
Once you say 504. You know what I'm saying? You don't need to say that much.
Sackalette time, y'all. Sackalette time. The weather.
Good sackalette, Ricky.
We can do something before this weather can get on us.
Good sackalette, Ricky.
Yeah. You all right.
Another nice little sackalette, Iggy.
Oh, yeah. Little sackalette.
Yeah, little sackalette.
Pan fried. Pan fried. Sackalette, y'all. Sackalette in the rain. Sackalette. Sackalette in the rain, y'all. Nice
sackle.
Nice.
What
you got
there, huh? Hand tied jig. Sackle, sackle. Sackle, sackle. Well, it's getting ready to change on us, right? But it sounds like it's going around us. If it does, that we're good.
Sackle, sackle, y'all. Sackle. That's what we're doing out here. To get y'all King Sackle beat.
Sackalette, okay. Another sackalette.
bulls running.
Yeah, they run.
Saturday, Saturday, pan fries, y'all. Honk say he'll cook her. Gonna let him cook it up. Oh, yeah. Little bitty baby Saturday. Let it go back to the mama. Yeah, let it go back to the mama, grow up. Catch you next time. Don't come back on that hook now. Might not have a chance to let you go again, you know, Honk. Honk say you fry him up. You fry him up now. What you got? Catfish.
Channel cat.
Got a double here, on. Sackley. Little baby Sackley, on. What are you, mama?
Little Sackley.
Yeah, they on.
Another channel catfish.
Channel catfish, on. What are you?
Jumping on that pan tide, yeah.
You got there, on? What you got there, on?
Nice Sackley, okay.
What are you looking for,
on? Nice Sackley. Late eating Sackley. Oh, yeah. He smells like Crisco.
Oh,
smells like Crisco.
Big red belly, y'all. Big red belly. Look at that. Look at that. Look at that. Big red belly, yeah. That's about the same size Sackley I've been catching, y'all. Yes, indeed. Sackley, y'all. Lady, you Sackley. You're looking like Lady, you Sackley, y'all. Got your own.
It's canal catfish.
Canal cat.
Bite it. They eat it.
Sackley, y'all. Lady, even Sackley.
What you got, young? Well, you see what it is? Lord, my bass fell victim. It's like magic. Like a chartreuse.
Nice one, okay.
Respectable box of fish, dude.
Had a good day today. Fishing in the rain. Got a late start. I think we did all right for the circumstances, huh? Got a nice box of fish. Got a box of fish on.
Oh yeah.
Got a variety of fish on. Got some chinkapin, bass, sackalay, catfish. Think we did all right for the circumstances, huh?
Oh yeah.
What you think, huh?
Well, I think it turned out nicely. Got a late start, had that storm front move through, and but it never did come right at us. We caught the fringe rains that as it blew by, but it came out of the south southwest, and it was moving north northeast. So we missed that, but we did get some rain. We got a little bit of wind, but that was it. We heard lightning and thunder off in the distance. And we're very fortunate in that regard, no issues. Had to work for every fish we caught today. No pattern, anything like that, no accumulation of fish we got on. We just had to work for the ones we got. And got a nice box for half a day of fishing. So it worked out okay.
That's right, y'all. Y'all don't forget to go to YouTube and subscribe. And take a screenshot or subscribe number, email us at erkunk@yahoo.com. That's erk, E-R-K, unk, U-N-K, @yahoo.com. We're going to go ahead and put it down. We're going to see y'all next time. Later.
Down to rock and roll.
Down to rock and roll. On. Put it down.